Today we're in the kitchen. Bam, 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 bam. We're doing a little cooking class because I don't actually know why. So I said this in a couple other videos, but I am Italian.
Italian.
Italian, yes.
I grew up around a bunch of women and men who were in the kitchen constantly. Everyone cooks in my family. So me being the youngest, naturally, I picked up a few things. Bam, 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 bam. It's also good, in my opinion, for men to know how to cook. I don't know, and maybe this is just me, but personally, I know I have wowed a lot of people with my cooking skills. I think it's an attractive trait. The one thing that I think is so important to know how to cook is breakfast. I'm a huge egg guy. Now, eggs for a while have had a bad reputation, okay? You know, you should
limit your egg intake.
Well, all that shit has basically been debunked, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. Eggs are good. Eggs are good for you. You can literally eat eggs every day, and it's okay. Like I said, we'll get into that in a little bit. Why am I gonna teach you how to make eggs? Breakfast can be a make it or break it situation in a lot of different capacities. I mean, let me paint this picture for you, okay? You're out, you meet someone, you have a great night. You take them home, you continue to have a great night. You wake up the next morning, you make them a shitty breakfast. Or no breakfast at all. Think you're getting a call back? I don't know, but I'll tell you something. If you make a mean breakfast, you're getting a call back.
Hello.
Hello, Cindy.
And they're telling their friends about you in the best way. Be like, wow, you know, we went out, we had a great time, we went home together, woke up in the morning, and he made me the best scrambled eggs I ever had. I don't know about you, but that sounds like the beginning of a fucking rom-com to me. So, I saw this video where Gordon Ramsay taught somebody, I forget who the hell he was teaching, how to make incredible scrambled eggs.
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
Now, could you exit out of my video and just go see Gordon Ramsay make it himself? Abso-fucking-lutely. But you know what? You're already this far into the video, so you may as well just stick around. Scrambled eggs are something that are super easy to make, and also just like, when you do it right, kind of impressive.
How do I open the egg? I don't know how to. Useless.
It's memorable, shows that you care, shows you kind of have your shit together a little bit, just a little bit. Right? I mean, you've got your skincare, you've got your hair care, and hey, you cook too. What doesn't this guy do? Holy shit.
Look at us. Look at us. Huh? Who would have thought?
Not me.
So I figured that this would be a good video. I could show y'all how to do it. I'm also gonna show you how to cut an avocado easily. The best way to make toast. It's a little controversial, but it is what it is. Alright, I'm gonna take the camera off the tripod. We're gonna do this. We're gonna need eggs. Stop moving eggs. Butter. Bread for toast. Chives. Salt and pepper. It's pretty basic. Oh, and an avocado. And actually, I don't even use a frying pan. Instead of using a frying pan, use something like this. You actually don't wanna whisk the eggs before you put them in the pan. Why? Apparently, they get runny, they cook faster, it's just like, or they turn gray or something. I don't know. Listen, I just follow the instructions, okay? I do what I'm told here. Now, for the record, I'm no master chef. So on medium heat, first spray that shit. Now, you're gonna crack the eggs directly into the frying pan. And, or whatever the fuck you call this thing. It's not a frying pan, but we're gonna call it a frying pan because I don't know what it's actually called. Oh, I already fucked up. Got a shell in there, okay? Great. Now, while the eggs are in there, you're also gonna put a little bit of butter with the eggs. Not a lot, just like, okay, I guess that's kind of a lot. You're gonna start to stir the eggs. You don't want to season the eggs yet.
Don't season the eggs until last.
Mixing it all together, okay? The butter and the eggs. So now, as they're cooking, every 30 seconds, you're gonna take them off the heat and continue to mix. Then put them back on the heat for another 30 seconds. Or like roughly 30 seconds, right? We're kind of just, we're winging it here. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't stop beating those eggs. Beat those eggs like you beat. I was about to say, beat those eggs like you beat your meat, but I just don't know if that's appropriate for a cooking video. But we said it anyways. And now we take it off the heat again. Okay, so now that we're at this consistency, what Gordon Ramsay does at this point is he adds a little bit of
cream fraiche, cafeteria fraiche.
I'm not nearly as classy. I add a piece of American cheese because I'm a piece of shit. So,
bam!
Continue to mix. Now it's off, okay? The burner's off at this point. Now you're just mixing together the cheese and the eggs. Which look bomb, by the way. Yeah. See that consistency? That's what we're looking for. So let's talk about toast now. Things get a little controversial here because a lot of people don't make their toast this way. I butter my bread before I put it in the toaster. Also, sourdough, okay? I'm not a nuts and seeds. I get the whole wheat, whole grain, healthy. I get it. But like, I don't like nuts and seeds in my bread. I don't wanna munch into my bread and get a fucking seed.
My tooth!
Not my vibe. Sourdough. I like to butter my bread before I put it in the toaster. A lot of people will say,
oh, this is gonna cause a grease fire.
It's never caused a grease fire for me. Regardless, I actually don't even use a normal toaster anymore because I got an air fryer. So, to each his own. Just make a piece of toast, all right? So while the toast is toasting, let's talk about the avocado. I am about to show you the easiest way to cut an avocado. I get it. A lot of people are probably like, what do you mean? You just cut the fucking avocado. Which yes, you can. You can just cut it down the middle. Totally works. But if you cut it down the middle only, okay, so we've cut it down the middle. But now if you only cut it down the middle once, when you open it up, the seed or the nut, whatever the fuck, that the giant, the pit, that thing, it doesn't come out very easily. Now, if you cut it down the middle and then down the middle one more time. So essentially you're cutting the avocado into fours. Now watch this. Watch this madness. One piece, two pieces, three pieces, and hey, four. It comes right out. See ya.
Bye, bitch.
The seed just pops right out if you cut it into fours. So, you're welcome. Let's assemble this bitch. Yes, yes, yes. A little bit of pepper. A bit of salt. Put some chives on top. Oh yeah.
Oh yeah!
Okay, is it the most gorgeous thing in the world? No. Could my presentation be better? Probably. Last thing I do, Frank's hot sauce. Not just because it has my name. I'm originally from Buffalo, New York. Frank's Red Hot is like fucking gold, okay? I love sriracha too, don't get me wrong, big sriracha guy, but if I'm going straight hot sauce, Frank's. I literally put that shit on everything. That's the actual tagline.
I put that on everything.
I truly do put this shit on everything. Holy shit. Well, I did it again. Okay, now let's talk about eggs real quick. For a long time, people said,
oh, eggs are actually bad for you. The cholesterol, it's awful.
That has actually been debunked, and I did a little bit of research. My source is straight from WebMD. So, anyways, eggs are one of the most powerful superfoods on the planet. Here's why you should be eating them. They're nutrient dense, okay? They are rich in a diverse array of nutrients, protein, healthy fats, powerful antioxidants, vitamins B12, B2, A, D, E, and K.
What could, should, hood? Good mug, dug, bug.
Oh, if we say we'll come, will you shut your ass up?
Basically, they're nature's multivitamin. Okay. Here's the kicker. Heart health, okay? Healthy fats from eggs are great for your heart. The mix of monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fats improve cholesterol level, upkeep hormone regulation, and reduce the risk of heart disease. If you heard eggs are bad for your heart, it was a lie. So seven reasons you should basically be eating your eggs: eye health, skin health, bone health, brain health, heart health, nutrient dense, and weight management. The part that makes the eggs bad for you is what you're eating with the eggs, right? So I probably shouldn't have put a piece of American cheese in my eggs. But like everything else, there's an avocado on here, there's chives, eggs, and yeah, okay, eat it without the toast. I get it. Regardless, it's super fucking good. Thank you for coming to my cooking class. I hope that this was helpful. Bam, 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 bam. But I do just wanna say, Thank you to everybody who's been watching my videos, and I'm loving the comments, loving the community. And honestly, I'm just glad that we're having a good time here. I hope that you're gaining some sort of something from my videos. I get it. Now, I'm not always gonna make the perfect video. Like this one, I feel like it's kind of shit. But also, I'm like very passionate about these scrambled eggs. If you like them, let me know in the comments. If you hate them, also let me know in the comments. If you have any other tips that I should be trying, let me know. Okay, great. Thanks for coming to cooking class. See y'all next week.